Ivan almost drowned. He literally almost died in the water. Good morning, Sarji family. Welcome back to another vlog. Hope you're having a wonderful day. It is early in the morning right now. Shadi's sleeping and Ronya is sleeping. I'm trying not to wake them up, so I'm speaking a little bit low, but I am starting off today's vlog. I'm going to the beach today here in the neighborhood at our house for the last time of this trip. I'm going to do some spear fishing today with Ivan. I'm excited about that. He's actually in the driveway right now fixing the spear gun. We're about to go hit the beach and catch some fish. Hoping we can catch something bigger and better than what we caught the last time. As you guys remember, the last time, which I actually uploaded on my main channel, I caught my first ever fish, my first time ever shooting a spear gun. First shot, first kill, was super happy about that. And then Ivan caught a red snapper and I ended up eating that one because my fish turned out to be poisonous. If you didn't see that video, I'll leave a link for that down below. The man, the myth, the legend. Bro, I have a couple girls on my channel that wanna marry you. He's got no comments for that. He's like my wife will shoot them. And before we get into today's video, I want to let you guys know about my awesome merch line, the Ghost Hunter Live a Little Merch Edition. The links for it are going to be down below. A lot of you guys were mind blown with this merch when you received it. A lot of you guys sent me pictures and I posted you on my vlog channel. Now, because you guys absolutely love this merch, I kept it going. I increased the merch limit and I want to keep this on the merch store for a little bit longer just so you guys can get yourself some Christmas merch. This new merch line is honestly amazing. I absolutely love it. We got different types of sweaters. We got stickers. We got a zip-up hoodie. We got t-shirts. We got another type of zip-up hoodie and a hoodie that you can actually slip on, as you guys can see. These Ghost Hunter LEL hoodies are honestly really, really comfortable. You got the LEL brand on the back, which is my brand right here. Live a little, guys, if you don't know what that means. If you're not into hoodies that you can slip on, we got the zip-up hoodie, as you guys can see over here. And we also have the LEL on the back of that. And if you're not into hoodies and you want to wear a t-shirt like I'm wearing right now, get yourself the Ghost Hunter t-shirt. The link is down below. We also have the LEL on the back of the t-shirt as well. These are really comfortable, they're really cool, and they fit the body really well. One thing I'm loving about this jersey style sweater is that how big the LEL marking is on the back. People can see you from a mile away when you wear this. And obviously on the front of it, we have the Ghost Hunter logo. As you guys can see, it's nice and big. And this type of sweater was surprisingly comfortable. And I know a lot of you guys ended up getting some of these. And if you did, make sure to send me photos of you wearing it so I can post pictures of you guys wearing them on my social media and on the vlog channel. Can't forget that I have the Ghost Hunter stickers as well. You can post these on your laptop. You can post these on your windows, on your walls, wherever the hell you want to post these. I want to see you guys grabbing a whole bunch of these. Links are gonna be down below. Get yourself that Christmas merch before Christmas is over. I know you probably want to get your friends, your family, your goldfish, your dog, your cat some gifts, so get them while you can. The Ghost Hunter merch is really awesome, guys. It's honestly some of the best stuff that I've ever created, and I want to share them with you guys, so the links are gonna be down below. Now let's get into this video. I was hoping the conditions at our beach would be amazing today, and they are just that. They are so amazing. It's pretty calm for this side. I've never seen it this calm before. We might get lucky on today's dive. The fact that there's not too many waves. The last time we dove here and we actually caught something, we had a strong current and the waves were crazier. But this is just, wow, guys, look at this. It's nice and peaceful and calm here, safe to swim. And there's a big cruise ship way back there in the background. I see it all the way down there. But yeah, man, this is gonna be so much fun. I can't wait. Hopefully we get something really big and really yummy to eat on my last dive here before I head back to Canada tomorrow. Man, I sure am gonna miss this place. I'm not gonna lie, I feel really depressed today that this is my last day for now until we come back. We are going, as I said in yesterday's vlog, we are going back to Canada for 2 weeks, and then we're traveling to another destination that we're gonna be gone for a little while. And yeah, I just love being here. Best choice that I've ever made in my life was buying a house out here, especially in this neighborhood. You know, we have this, our own beach here, which is really, really beautiful. And when the conditions are right, it's just extra gorgeous. So Ivan and I decided we're gonna go and dive way down there where the wave breaks are. because there might be something different over there since we've already explored this area. There's a couple caves down there which we showed you last time, but we're gonna go all the way down there and hopefully find something better.
All right, here we go. This should be fun. I can't wait to do this. Loving the conditions right now. As I said before, this is awesome. I'm actually wearing gloves this time because I learned one thing on the last one. Fish are sharp. Their skin can cut you. So don't underestimate a fish. Just because it looks nice and soft doesn't mean it is. And also, there's poisonous fish out there. So having gloves is a bonus. He got caught on the rock with a rope.
The camera fell off my hand.
As long as you're okay. That was almost really bad. Woo! So we have this bottle tied to us where we tie the fish to it so the fish stays away. In case we capture any fish, barracuda isn't gonna bite our hips if the fish are at our hips. But he was trying to go under the rock and the rope got stuck. Yo, you almost drowned, man.
I was gonna rip that shit apart.
Yeah, Jesus. Oh, oh yeah. Look at what it eat. Woo! Instant kill right there.
You got it, bro. Woo!
Look at what it eat. Woo! Wow, what a catch, eh? This is like the biggest one we found so far.
This is the only one worth shooting out there.
I wonder what kind of fish this is, what's it called? It looks like it's edible at least. It doesn't look poisonous.
It is.
Look at the colors and the design on this thing. This thing died almost immediately after shot. Look, I shot it right there.
Yeah.
Probably cracked its spine or something.
Yeah.
Wowee! So we're actually going to donate this fish to the restaurant over here because, you know, they cook up fresh fish, whatever people bring them sometimes.
It feels like it has a pearl inside.
You think so? A pearl?
Do that?
I don't feel a pearl. No, there's no pearl.
Those are oysters, I got.
Yeah. That's a nice fish, though. Man. Yeah, we weren't finding too many big fish. Just a lot of small ones. Nothing worth actually getting. Until he pointed this one out, it was deep down there under a rock, and I went down there, I took my time, and I blasted it.
You got him good, though.
Yeah,
you
love it.
Good.
Hell yeah. That was definitely well worth it. That was a cool and fun adventure. We didn't catch too many, and honestly, the whole goal was to just to spear a fish today and then donate it. He's going to donate it to the restaurant there. They'll cook it up and serve it to someone. So I'm really happy with that. But Ivan almost drowned. He literally almost died in the water. He got caught on the rock, and every time waves came, it was sinking him under, and he couldn't get up for air. And luckily, I looked back just in time, and I seen him in trouble. So I went down there, and I cut the rope with the knife, and he was able to get free. The reason why we tie that rope to our waist is because if you put the fish on your waistband, like some people do, barracudas can come and take a bite out of you while they're trying to take a bite of the fish, or a shark or something. Something could actually kill you. We'll see if the lady likes the fish. Ask her what kind of fish, if she knows what that is.
No, I guess we'll find it later because...
Yeah?
Yeah, you might want to get her on
the plate,
right?
A what?
You might want to take a picture of
it. Yeah, yeah, no, it's okay. Does she know what kind of fish that is?
¿Tú sabes cómo se llama eso?
Este no. No sé cómo se llama. Yo no había visto de ese.
Sí, pero ese se come.
Ah, ok. Por eso le pregunté porque no lo había visto de este, ¿no?
Sí, ese fue el más grande que pudimos.
We donate our catch. There we go, guys. We didn't let it go to waste. We donated our catch. Hey, bro. How does it feel to almost drown?
Actually, I was aware of that.
Yeah, yeah.
I was aware of that. And I was like, I was just so stubborn. I didn't think that this little bit of air can actually drown me, bro. You know?
You're officially my Rennie of Dominican Republic. My friend Rennie, every time he comes out with me on a video, he gets injured. He gets injured or almost dies or something. You're my Rennie of Dominican.
He came down and cut the rope.
Yeah. Rennie, every time we go somewhere with Rennie, he gets injured or almost dies or breaks his balls. The last video we filmed together, which I haven't even uploaded yet, he hurt his groin really bad. So you guys will see that video in the near future. But what an awesome adventure. This will probably be the last time you guys see Ivan for a little while. So goodbye to Ivan. Oh, by the way, I told him in yesterday's vlog that you found the German lady and she got her Rolex back. So I was really happy about that.
Yeah, man.
So that was really cool. We reunited.
She was amazed with that, bro. I felt like a hero, bro.
So that's awesome that we reunited her with a Rolex. And jumping into the day, I am here reunited with Shadia. Hello, Shadia. What's going on? Why do you look like that? Shadia is in a really grumpy mood, guys.
What are you? Stop. That visitor, that monthly visitor.
I hate it.
Why does it always come every month? I don't get it. Why does it just go away? Like, come once a year or something.
But we have Rania over here. We're about to go out for a walk. Hi, Rania.
You want to vlog? All right, here you go. You can hold the vlog camera. All right, you're vlogging now. I think this vlog camera might be a little bit too big for Rania. Hi, Rania. Say hello. I love that smile. Well, I love the smile on her face whenever she holds the vlog camera. It's so funny. I look really dark, and that's because I'm really tanned. We're heading to the hotel in our neighborhood. We're going to go for a walk. We're going to go grab a bite to eat at the restaurant. We were supposed to go meet up with some friends and for dinner, but Shad is not feeling it. I am exhausted too. Literally, we had a crazy day on the ocean today. Like, Ivan literally almost died. I didn't show you guys this on camera because both my cameras died. As I was almost out of the water, I got so seasick and so motion sick from the waves and stuff and being in the water for so long that I literally barfed. I puked everything. Yeah, and I still feel nauseous because we've been swimming a lot, we've been diving a lot, and like I feel very, very nauseous because I literally feel like I'm still on the waves right now. That's how bad it is, and that's how much time we've been spending on the waves, me and Ivan. And we're not going to see Ivan anymore in these vlogs, not until we come back here sometime in the near future. I loved seeing Ivan. I loved meeting Ivan. Really amazing dude. He's a good friend of mine now here, and I'm happy to film with him all the time and hang out with him all the time. He's become like family for us here in the Dominican Republic, and I'm really, really grateful to meet such an amazing person. I literally had to save him today, Shadia. His rope that was tied to his waist got stuck under a rock. And if I hadn't gone back to see, check on him, he was under the water and like kind of struggling for air because the waves were going on top. So if I hadn't gone down and cut that rope quickly, he probably would have drowned or ripped off his shorts.
I would have already drowned and died if it was me.
Yeah, you probably would have. But like, you wouldn't be out there either.
So you would be laughing at me too when we go into the water.
Yeah, Shadda can't swim. But that's why like it's so dangerous what we do and like going spearfishing. Is really, I mean, I'm sure he would have been last resort. I'm sure he would have like ripped off his shorts because they were tied to his shorts. But at the same time, you never know what could have happened. Like if it was someone else could have panicked, could have drowned, could have died. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's why it's very important not to panic. And even though you feel like you're drowning or dying, always think, always try to keep it upon you to think as much as you can.
I'm the worst when it comes to panicking.
Shadow would just probably let yourself die.
No, you don't understand. I literally have a fear of water, anything water. Like, if the world were to end and it would be flooded, I would, like, die
from that. She would just probably die before the water even reaches her.
Yeah, exactly.
Not me, though. I like to survive. I'm a survivor. You guys ready to go eat? On our last walk in the neighborhood.
I'm tired.
It's our last walk. Well, no, you're not dying, you're fine. Let's go. I just asked Shadia, why are you wearing black? Like, she's like, it's a funeral day for me today.
Yeah, my visitor comes, it's a funeral.
Yeah, so take a good look at everything here, guys. At our yard, at our front here. This is all going to be changed by the time we get back here, probably. Because I'm building a high wall, and I'm building a gate for my driveway. Like, this is a private driveway, only the people that live here. There's only four houses here. And only the people that live in these four houses and are allowed to be in here. But I'm putting in a nice big gate here, nice big wall so nobody can get through to make it just more safer and more private. Are you dying? All right, let's go. We got a bit of a walk. One of my most favorite things to do every day, like I do this every day with Rania, is walk her down this driveway. Like we go for a walk every day and she'll walk by herself. And I just absolutely love the driveway. It's so like, there's so many like trees and bushes and different colors. And that is literally my favoriteest part about this driveway. Like it's so awesome, it's so cool. And I'm really gonna miss it. Like I will miss it. Like I'm already depressed that we have to go back. And we only have to go back because we have to do something important that popped up. And we're only gonna be back in Canada for 2 weeks until we go on our next trip. And very excited about the next trip. It's just not gonna be like this type of destination. So yeah, it's cool though. Oh, just realized I forgot my phone. Chad is just gonna go on ahead to the... One of the things I'm really gonna miss is all the flowers, guys. It's so nice to see floral everywhere. So beautiful. Ronnie, you're on camera. Ronnie's being a bad girl, guys. She's throwing her food all over the ground. Ronnie, you're being a bad girl right now. Guys, I'm gonna miss this view. I love coming here. We just ordered our food. We're waiting on our food right now. We're always the only ones here. I mean, there's usually people here, but when we come, it's usually like kind of dead. but I'm gonna miss that swimming pool. What, is she throwing her food? Like, actually, Rania.
Oh, you're gonna have to clean that up. That's really bad.
Say hi. I love how for the camera she's acting different. You're acting fresh for the camera. Say hello. Say hi. Yeah. Enough camera. I'm gonna pretend like I'm gonna turn the camera away. She's probably gonna throw all the food.
You eat it when she goes.
I know, it sucks. We're known for that. Every time we go to a restaurant, they know us because Rania always tosses her food on the ground. Uh-oh. Look at this. We got a nice virgin pina colada right here. Food is about to show up. I can't wait. We actually ordered a lot of food.
Let's just hope it's not too creamy because I don't like this.
That's what she said.
I like it when it's more pineapple-y.
Oh, yeah, that's what she said. I can eat pineapple for you.
Oh, baby, this looks so yummy. Rania got herself a cheese quesadilla. She's been loving these. Shadi got some nachos.
And I got some prawns over here. That looks so freaking yummy. About to destroy those.
I am going to go ahead and end off this vlog. I don't think it was that long of a vlog. I don't know what I filmed. I think I just filmed us diving in the water and then going out to eat. But we've been busy packing all our stuff. We're heading home tomorrow, guys, and I'm not looking forward to it. We are leaving a lot of stuff behind here because obviously it's our home and we're coming back. And it's just things that, instead of bringing back with us every time, we're gonna leave it here. We're like locking it in this closet and just a whole lot of stuff that we actually brought with us. We brought 6 luggage bags with us and we're leaving with like 3. So I'm happy, I'm really happy about that. Because if it's one thing that put me through so much stress is coming up here with 6 big luggage bags, plus like 2 carry-ons, actually 3 carry-ons, and Rania's car seat and her stroller. So we have such a burden lifted off of us by leaving so much stuff here. Smash the like button. Thank you guys for all the love and support. Get yourself some Live a Little merch. The link is down below. And you guys probably noticed I kept the merch going, and it's because you guys demanded it. Rania, say bye. Rania's like, no, I see candy. I see candy. Go get your candy. Go get your candy. Oh, you want the vlog camera? Okay. Just don't drop it. This one's the heavy one. That's not how you vlog. Hello. There you go. This girl is going to be a vlogger and she's going to have her own channel really, really soon. I can't wait. Be you, do you, stay positive and just live a little. It's been fun, Dominican Republic. Tomorrow's vlog is going to be a travel day back home to Canada for only 2 weeks. Oh, I have to say that because I don't want to go back home. Like, I was looking at my cameras and there's snow all over my stairs. Like, I have to go home and shovel. Like, I have a snowplow service that cleans my driveway, but the guy's lazy and doesn't clean the actual staircase and the porch. That being said, I'm probably gonna have to shovel some snow tomorrow. We love you guys from the bottom of our hearts. Be you, do you, stay positive, and just live a little. We out.